this. Sir Coleman was just knighted by Her Majesty the Queen right here. Shut up!
Sorry, I always get adorable and brave children mixed up with cowards wet themselves. He bravely wet himself at the Prattle of Betty.
Right.
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 Yes,
yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm going to be so warm back.
Golds and Mayonnaise, I am Will Shakespeare, which means you should cheer now! When I say you should cheer, now I need to go and say, hoot, holler, cut, cheer, stomp your feet, whistle, and throw small loved ones into the air. I am Will Shakespeare, and you should cheer now! Thank you for thrilling the brave Sir Coleman. Now, friends, this story's audience interaction with tweets requires all of your help. So when I say everybody says, ooh, I need to hear all of you say, ooh. Everybody says, ah.
Ah.
Bum, bum, bum.
We have not very dramatic music. We have random sound effects of randomness. And we start off with a song. Take your hands. Hit your lap two times. Clap your hands once. Do it again. 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 Hickory witches. She's just giggling. And with the voice of the crowd entire behind them, they sing these words of incantation. They say, double, double toil and trouble.
Double, double toil and trouble.
Fire burn in cauldron bubble.
Fire burn in cauldron bubble.
By the pricking of my thumbs.
By the pricking of my thumbs.
Something wicked this way comes.
Something wicked this way comes.
Who should it be who but the titular character of Macbeth, Death by Fluffy Kittens. His name is Macbeth, and you know it is he because he is a ginger. Now, he is joined by his best friend and boon companion, Banquo, as played by that kid in the red shirt. What? Now, Banquo's a bit of a yes man, and he always says, yup.
Yep.
Now, the witches say, Hail Macbeth!
Hail Macbeth!
Lord of Glamis!
Lord of Glamis!
Hail Macbeth!
Hail Macbeth!
Lord of Cawdor!
Lord of Cawdor!
Hail Macbeth!
Hail Macbeth!
He who shall be king!
He who shall be king!
And the witches three cackled and laughed. And they run away laughing into the night, which means sit down. Macbeth, very casually apparently, is like, hey, what's up? Turns to Banquo, and he says, well, that was bloody weird.
That was bloody weird.
And Banquo says, well done. He says, they called me king.
They called me king.
And Banquo says, uh-huh. That obviously can't happen.
That obviously can't happen.
And Banquo says, ha-ha, it's a strict question. For me to be king.
For me to be king.
We would have to first kill my cousin, the king.
We'd have to first kill my cousin, the king.
Have his sons driven from the land.
Have his sons driven from the land.
And the nobles declare me king.
And the nobles declare me king.
And Banquo says,
yep.
Ha-ha. Now, Banquo writes a letter to his wife. It says, dear wife.
Dear wife.
Something weird happened today.
Something really weird happened today.
I met three witches.
I met three witches.
They called me king.
They called me king.
It obviously can't happen.
It obviously can't happen.
Love Macbeth.
Love Macbeth.
P.S.
P.S.
We're having a sleepover.
We're having a sleepover.
Please make brownies.
Make brownies.
He mails the letter to his wife. She jumps up reading it and exclaims, my husband shall be king! No, we know she is Lady Macbeth because she is also a ginger. No. Macbeth says, how will this happen?
How will this happen?
And she says, it's all so simple.
It's all so simple.
All we have to do,
all we have to do
is kill your cousin, the king.
Is kill your cousin, the king.
Have his sons driven from the land.
Have his sons driven from the land.
And the nobles declare you king.
And the nobles declare you king.
And Banquo says,
yep.
Which is weird because he wasn't even there for the conversation. At this point, who should enter but the King of Scotland, Duncan, this man holding a small child. And you know he is king because he is wearing a red shirt. And everyone says, Hail to the King!
Hail to the King!
It's good to be king.
It's good to be king.
He says, Hail Macbeth!
Hail Macbeth.
My cousin!
My cousin.
My brother!
My brother.
My bestie!
My bestie.
I feel safe in your home.
I feel safe here.
Nothing bad could ever happen to me here. This is the best sleepover ever. Thanks for the brownies. And he goes to bed. Now, Lady M turns to her husband and says, if it were done.
If it were done.
Twere better if it were done quickly.
Twere better if it were done quickly.
Do it!
Do it!
Kill him!
Kill him!
Be a man!
Be a man!
And Banquo says,
yep.
Still weird.
Still not there.
At this point, Macbeth delivers a soliloquy. That's a big word. Everyone say it with me.
Soliloquy.
Soliloquy is when one person, in this case Macbeth, is talking to you, the audience directly, but no one else in the show can hear. So, Banquo, Lady M, Sleeping King,
yeah, muffs.
He comes to the stage, holds out his hand dramatically. He says, is this a dagger I see before me?
This is a dagger I see before me?
No, it's a fluffy kitten. For there is something so trash, more deadly in the entire universe known as an adorable fluffy kitten. The earmuffs come off, and he sneaks into the king's bedchamber, replete with sneaking music provided by Yule.
Dun, dun, dun.
No, sneaking, not dramatic. He puts the kitten into the bed, runs away giggling. The king awakes. He stands, so you can see the tragedy unfold. He sees the kitten and says, "Aww." And so do all of you.
Aww.
The kitten begins to purr. Let me hear it purr. It begins to meow. Let me hear it meow. It licks his cheek with scratchy tongue. No, it hurts so much. No, it begins to love. But how is he loved?
To death!
Die! All dead! All the way dead! Stick your tongue out so we know it's real. Stop giggling. Death isn't funny. Shout, "The king is dead!
The king is dead!"
His two children, Malcolm and the other one, she stands. Says, "I'm Malcolm. I'm the other one." And they say, "Our dad is dead! Let's run away to England! There's nothing weird or suspicious about that!" And they run away to England. Sit down. Now, the noble shouts, "The sons have..." "The sons have fled!
The sons have fled!
Make Macbeth the king!"
"Make Macbeth the king!"
His wife says, "Yeah, baby!"
"Yeah, baby!"
And Macbeth says, "It's good to be king!"
"It's good to be king!"
And that ends Act One!
Woo!
Days go by. You can sit up now, it's fine. Several days go by. We know that time has passed because they're all standing in a different spot on stage. Banquo goes up to his friend Macbeth and he says, "My lord Macbeth." "I thought you didn't know Banquo knew other words." He says, "I, Banquo, need to go do something. I need to take care of my banquet." And the best says, "Keg."
"Keg."
"Hard."
"Bye-bye."
And he goes, "Well, now, lady of a princess in house." And she says, "You must kill Banquo." He says, "Why?"
"Why?"
"He's my best friend."
"He's a bestie."
I love when actors make it their own.
Good call.
Stands and says, "My lord Macbeth."
"My lord!"
loud voice. He says, "Something weird is happening in our nation.
Something weird is happening in our nation.
We have far too many cats in the kingdom.
We have far too many cats in our kingdom.
I'm going to England to investigate.
I'm going to England to investigate."
And Macbeth says,
Okay.
Bye.
Bye.
What are you doing
in England?
Now. Thank you.
Red shirt.
Lady M turns to her husband and she says, "You must kill Macduff." He says, "Why?
Why?
He's a good man.
He's a good man.
I was going to have him for tea.
I'm going to have him for tea."
She goes, "He wants to be king." He goes, "I can't kill him though.
Can't kill him though.
He's in England.
He's in England.
He has diplomatic immunity.
He has diplomatic immunity."
Yes. "Kill the family then.
Kill the family.
Kill the wife. Kill the children. Kill that dog.
Kill them.
And there is dramatic music." You know, she said that last part because she's the ginger. It's been scientifically proven they have no souls. Now, he calls me the messenger. He says, "Messenger!
Messenger!"
She runs forward.
Oh, not with the turkey legs.
"Messenger!
Messenger!
You know what to do.
You know what to do."
She shoots him. "Says, aye, aye, Captain.
Still weird, still the king."
Now, she goes off to the Macduff family. She goes to Mrs. Macduff, this lady here, in the coral. It's close enough to Raggedy. She goes to the older jaded teenage daughter of Macduff, that lady eating beefaroni or something. Hand it off, you don't want to spill.
Yes.
Hurry. And thank you. She goes to the next door neighbor of Macduff, Uncle Slappy. She goes to the tiny little child of Macduff who never did anything bad to anybody. This little girl with a turkey leg. Smile. She goes to the dog.
We find
find out days after the battle. Because, yeah, it's a battle, why not? That even though she should have been killed, she was alive! Her name is Connor McLeod of the Clan McLeod. And she is immortal! No! And so, Jerry, sick, twisted, evil person that Jerry is.
Come in, Jerry.
She goes to McDuff. She comes over here. She goes to
Turkey's hanging out.
Hail, McDuff!
Hail!
I am the king's messenger. She strikes a dramatic pose and says, Jerry. Says, I've got good news and bad news. And McDuff says, well, what's the good news?
Well, what's the good news?
She says, you can follow Shakespeare on Twitter. At Shakes approves, go do it. I need followers. I'm emotionally needy. What's the bad news?
What's the bad news?
She says, your whole family's dead. Bye. She runs away laughing like a maniac. He says, all my chicks are dead.
All my chicks are dead.
All my little peeps.
All my little peeps.
I am not sponsored by the Marshmallow Peep Corporation, but if you know them, give them my name. He says, revenge.
Revenge.
He comes over here and says it again.
Revenge.
He goes to center stage.
No, you
can't. Let's not step on his dead family. He falls to his knees, beats his chest, raises his arms to heaven, and cries, revenge!
Revenge!
He beats his chest and cries, Con! He goes to the princes in exile, Malcolm and the other one. He says, I'm Malcolm. I'm the other one. He says, let's get revenge.
Let's get revenge?
They say, on who? He says, the guy who killed your dad.
The guy who killed your dad?
And they're like, oh yeah, him. And so they decide to get revenge, and they hire an army and all that. Just sit down. Meanwhile, the mortuary crew has come in and cleaned up the whole dead family.
Practically
this moment, the army bursts into the scene, as played by this lady here. She says, I'm the army. He says, that's great. I can't die. And he hits her with a cat. At this moment, McDuff bursts into the sea, and he turns to 3/4 pro miles, and he says, "Die, vile traitor!"
Die, world traitor!
No, vile traitor.
Vile.
Yeah.
Vile.
Yeah.
Die, vile traitor.
Yeah, I think the first time you said moral traitor. Die, you traitor, though with reasonably good ethics and morals. I know you did it in the name of good and righteousness.
I did it because my wife told me to.
She says, Don't you know?
That no man. A mortal woman born. Can harm Macbeth.
She says, Don't you know?
That Macduff.
Who is me?
From his mother's womb.
Was untimely ripped.
What does that mean?
He says, I was born. By C-section. That's fascinating. Yes, well, the more you know.
Yes, the more you know.
And a rainbow appears. He says, Lay on, McDuff. And we pause for a word from our hopeful one day, maybe sometime, sponsors, The Walking Dead. Thank you, guys. And so, they run away. And they face off against each other. We're back. Leon McDuff. And they arm themselves with cats. And there is dramatic fight music. They start to throw cats at each other. And there's cats. And more 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 cats. And innocent people get hit. And this is how Dodgeball was invented. Over the crowd.
Hush.
And the king's messenger comes into the room. She says, Hail, Macbeth!
I am the king's messenger.
She strikes her dramatic pose and says,
Jerry.
Well done. Do you like kings? Yes!
Yeah.
And then I will whisper her next line to her. Up opportunity to have the greatest job in the world, were I not here singing ridiculous songs and throwing cats at people, I would be at home, likely still singing ridiculous songs and throwing cats at my actual cat. But, you know, I might still be in this outfit. My friends, please go give me a like. The name of the show is Shakespeare Proofs. Like me on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, but never Snapchat. And whenever you feel today's show was worth a 1, a 5, a 10, 4, a 50, I will detail your car because I got no bribe. Throw it into my hat. If you throw in anything, you will go home with a token of my affection, a wooden nickel that says Shakespeare Proofs. It says to the entire world that I love you, even if you're setting your mother's curtains on fire. And in this election year, I will Shakespeare Proof of this message. Weather permitting, at 3:15, I will be back here with the Hamlet Christmas special, where everybody lives just this once. And at 6:30 with Titus Andronicus, you know, for kids. up next on the stage is Zoltan the Adequate. And in the meantime, I'm Will Shakespeare. I love you, you love me. You can cheer now.